Once irrigation maintenance was out of the way, the olives we'd harvested had a pressing engagement with a guy named Perry. He has a reputation for being kind of oily. At Queen Creek, though, that's not a bad thing. So Rob's out and Perry is in, and you run the joint.
I'm the man.
The man.
I'm the owner and the master blender. That's what I do.
So we've brought in your booty.
Yeah, you've got some nice manzanillo olives here. Very nice.
We don't have Mission in here, too?
Well, you have manzanillo on top, and it looks like you got Mission on the bottom. So you guys did three trees, huh?
We went crazy out there.
Yeah, you did.
We
you got good color, too.
So what do you call this little station here?
Well, this is our defoliator. So you know when you harvested, it looks like you picked up a few of the leaves and some of the stems.
I got rid of mine, but honestly, Rob, he drifted. He lost focus, and a lot of it got by him.
Well, this is our defoliator. A nice little machine, very easy machine to use. You ready?
I'm ready.
All right, so the burlap sack's got to go on first.
I will slow you down like you haven't been slowed down.
Yeah, I think so.
Here, hold that for me there, will you?
All right, good.
See, it's the little simple things.
The little things in life, huh? There you go.
Make sure, that's it. Go ahead, just pour them right in.
And what do you do with the leaves? Do you just throw them out, compost them?
Put them in compost. We'll throw them out with all the byproduct that comes with the machine.
That's a fancy word for crap.
Caca. Pumice. It's really important that we harvest the olives at the right time because a purple olive will give you an entirely different taste profile in oil than a green ripe olive. Green ripe's gonna give you a lot of fiery, peppery tasting oil, and a purple ripe olive's gonna give you really fruity, buttery tasting oil. You know, it's a family business. My wife always said, boy, it'd be really nice if we could do something kind of like a winery. So it kind of progressed into that concept where it's kind of like a winery where you can come out here, watch us make the olive oil.
What'd you do before this?
Before this, I was in the automotive industry. I tell people I went from motor oil to olive oil. This is a lot more fun. Now we get to go make some oil.
The principle behind making extra virgin olive oil is the same now as it was in the ancient world. And of course, so is the sole ingredient. However, the technology for pressing olives has come a long way in the last few thousand years. Before the olives go in the press, they get a cold bath to wash off any remaining dirt. Inside this machine, the olives are pulverized into a paste, which is then blended for about 45 minutes. While it's being blended, a process called malassation is taking place, during which the oil molecules adhere to each other. From there, the paste goes into a centrifuge, which spins to extract the oil. This is possible because oil is lighter than water. After the oil is removed, the paste exits the back of the machine as a waste product called caca.
Next thing we want to do is we just want to check the oil out a little bit. This is the fun part. Okay, now we're going to do a shooter of olive oil. This is going to be peppery, so I wouldn't knock the whole thing back if I were you. Salud. Maybe half of it.
Hi, ow.
Wow. Whew. This is the freshest oil you'll ever taste because as soon as it comes out of that spigot, it starts to degrade. Not like wine, doesn't get better with age.
Who loves pepper?
Oh yeah.
No, enjoy. Down a hatch. Delicious. I think he's allergic to pepper.
Good stuff. One last thing we gotta do is I think we better check the caca. How are we doing here?
The caca's backed up.
Okay, well, we'll move that out of the way, push it this way. There you go, perfect. Just in the nick of time.
Close one. What happens to your caca?
We compost it. The next year we'll put it back into our grove and disc it in, or we'll put it onto our road to keep the dust down, or we'll stick it in our garden.
You put your caca on the road to keep the desert dust down.
Yep.
That's great.
Yeah, works great.
Well, then what about getting the oil into the bottle?
Well, from here, what we do with the oil is we transfer it into a primary decanter because there's still a little bit of water left in this oil. So from there, let it decant. We'll take the water off the bottom. And then as the master blender, I gotta have some fun. Come January, I will begin to start blending the oil to come up with my Tuscan blend. And I really use my palate to do that.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, after the last batch of olives has been run through the machine, the press gets a thorough cleaning. machine has to be flushed and then broken down and cleaned once a week.
That's where the olives get introduced, and as it gets in here, it just keeps shoving the paste out here through these little holes.
Yeah.
Drops in here, it's this hammer. So you're gonna pull this off, and just by hand and by scraper, we'll take the rest of that muffa out of there.
Muffa, another fake word.
Yeah, when it's like this, it's muffa.
Right.
All right.
It's muffa.
You want an apron, Mike?
No. Aprons are for girls, Rob.
That's what I thought.
I didn't need Perry or Bob to show me how to operate the pressure washer. To be honest, I've lost track of how many times in the past I've used one of these. Never before have I used one to clean the centrifuge on an olive oil press. It's a first of a kind.
There's a steady flow in there and you're good.
Cleaning a centrifuge. Dirty job.
I'm up the caca hole.
Yeah, you're up the caca hole.
All right.
Every year, Queen Creek produces 4,000 gallons of extra virgin olive oil. And Perry, Rob, and the rest of the crew work all year round, picking, pressing, bottling, and getting dirty, so that you and I have oil to cook with, dress our salads, and dip our bread into.
Let me just genuinely say, as the sun goes down, thank you for having us and showing us the inside workings of not only a machine, but your entire business.
Thank you for coming. We appreciate it.
Thank you, Mike.
Pleasure. You're a smart fella for a marketing guy.
Thank you. Thank you, Mike.
And for a boss, you know.
Thanks, Mike.
People seem to like you. All right, so you got this?
Absolutely.
I got this. We're going to drive
I'll get
this
the
in. You get the caca.
All right.
All right.
2 buckets of caca. Still here? Good for you. It's funny. Done a lot of research on this show, and we've proven beyond a shadow of a doubt you'll watch anything. Stay here as long as you want. I'm leaving. That's a sunset. I'm walking into it.